Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
Tepaya.
Asam.
Yedasi.
Tepuhoya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Together we pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, have mercy on us. Immaculate Heart of Mary, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Michael, pray for us. All you saints and angels of God, pray for us. A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And the Lord was sorry that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him to his heart. So the Lord said, I will blot out man, whom I have created, from the face of the ground, man and beast and creeping things and birds of the air, for I am sorry that I have made them. But Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. Then the Lord said to Noah, go into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you are righteous before me in this generation. Take with you 7 pairs of all clean animals, the male and his mate, and a pair of the animals that are not clean, the male and his mate, and 7 pairs of the birds of the air also, male and female, to keep their kind alive upon the face of the earth. For in 7 days I will send rain upon the earth, 40 days and 40 nights, and every living thing that I have made, I will blot out from the face of the ground. And Noah did all that the Lord had commanded him, and after 7 days, the waters of the flood came upon the earth. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Beloved in Christ, on this Tuesday of the sixth week in ordinary time, year one, the Word of God continues to teach us very important lessons drawn from the stories of the creation of the universe, the origins of the universe. As I intimated yesterday, these stories in the book of Genesis do not claim to give us a scientific, a historical, a purely historical account. No. They give us an allegorical, a theological, and to some extent a philosophical account of how the universe came to be, how good and evil came to be, and some of the remedies, some of the mistakes and some of the remedies that were put in place to mitigate the evil effects, to mitigate or reduce the consequences of these effects of the evils of the use and abuse of free will that God gifted humankind with from the beginning of our existence. So when we say something is allegorical, it means it is not based on facts, scientific facts. It is not based on scientific evidence. Its predominant aim is to teach, is to give lessons, is to demonstrate certain deep meanings, certain deep truths about reality. So the accounts of Genesis from yesterday, talking about how Cain killed his own brother Abel out of jealousy, out of anger, out of, if you like, indignation at the treatment he received from God, which he felt was unjust, and taking things into his own hands, deciding that a violent means was his recourse, probably his only recourse, and suffering the consequences thereof. In today's reading, we hear of the story of how humankind further deviated from the purpose, from the will of God, the purpose for which it was created. Humankind was created for a purpose, for good, was created to share in God's glory, to be righteous, to follow the commandments of God that had been inscribed in human conscience, in what we can describe as the natural law. And yet humankind deviated. As we heard at the beginning of the reading, it says, the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. So that humankind that was created pure, that was created innocent, that was created, in as we heard in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 and 27, in the image and likeness of God, deviated from that, following the temptation of the evil one, listening and obeying the tempter, the devil, Satan, rather than obeying, rather than listening, rather than following the commandments of God. So this continued. Cain had killed Abel. Humankind continued to multiply sin upon sin, to disobey God. And we have an anthropomorphic language used. So that is to say, anthropomorphism. That is to say that human qualities are given or ascribed to God. So God is said to have regretted. God is said to have been sort of saddened or angry because the world he created did not turn out to be the way he had wished. As if to say that God had no idea that this could happen. But that is anthropomorphic language. And you can also see that in looking at the situation, God shows his love, shows his mercy, because he finds just one man, Noah, who was righteous. And for the sake of Noah, decides to give creation another chance, another opportunity. That contrary to the initial decision, God's initial decision to destroy the whole world by flood, he decided that he was going to pass through this one man. But this man, Noah, had to obey God, had to listen to God, had to believe what God was saying in order to be saved. So he had to listen, he had to believe, he had to obey. That is, he had to act, put into action what God had pointed out, what God had said. If God tells us something, if God wants to save me and directs me to someone or directs someone to me to give me his word, to give me the means or the steps I need to take in order to get out of that trouble, in order to have greater blessings, prosperity, breakthroughs, as you would like, in order to find healing, in order to find deliverance, I had better listened. I had better obeyed. If not, it will come to naught. We need to obey God. So Noah is asked to bring with him into the ark, not only his family, but the animals, the birds, and so on. Now, the Jewish concept of cleanliness and uncleanliness also makes its way into the text, which tells us that this text was written much, much later. It was not written at the beginning of creation, no. So it was written much, much later. And so the concept of animals that were clean or that were pure or that were wholesome, such as sheep and cows and so on, and animals that were impure or unwholesome, such as swine or pigs, makes its way here. That concept makes its way here. But interestingly, God permitted both the clean and unclean to enter into the ark. He preserved the clean and unclean for a purpose. Indeed, some church fathers have identified the ark as representing or being a figure that was to represent the church. So, like Noah's ark that had people and animals go in order to escape from the wrath of God and be saved, the church is the new ark. Is the new ark, the ark of Jesus, the ark that is the body of Christ, through which we are saved by the body, by the blood of Jesus, through his death and resurrection, through our faith, through our baptism, and through our obedience. My sheep listen to my voice. Jesus said that in John chapter 10, verse 27. They follow me. So we have to obey Jesus Christ. We have to obey his word. We have to study his word. And again, we are told that what God said would happen indeed did happen. So When God had instructed Noah, Noah obeyed. Indeed, 7 days after he had constructed the ark, and they had entered, the rain came, the thunderstorm came for 40 days and 40 nights. And we didn't read that in this text, but if we read the full text, we will see that people mocked Noah as he obeyed, as he urged them to run away from the wrath by entering the ark. When they realized that what God had said was going to happen, and they were knocking the ark, it was too late. The door had been shut. In Psalm 95, verse 1 and following, it says, "If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts." The invitation to salvation through repentance and forgiveness in Jesus Christ, or through Jesus Christ, is given to us, is offered to us freely today. But it shall not always be available. For there is going to be a day when judgment will come and repentance will no longer be possible. Yes, the world will end. Our individual lives will end. What am I doing with regard to Jesus' invitation to me to repent, to change my ways, to heed his invitation? May the Lord help us so that we do not fall prey to what Jesus warns us against in today's gospel, taken from Mark chapter 8, verse 14 through 21. He says, Jesus warns his disciples against the hardness of heart. You know, he warns them. Take heed, beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod. That is what Jesus Christ warned them against, that they may not have hardness of heart, that they may believe in his absolute power and authority to save. The Lord is inviting you to heed his invitation like Noah, to believe. And he's prepared to give us the grace to continue to carry our crosses and to follow him in spite of our weaknesses, in spite of our sins, because he loves us and does not want us to perish. May the Lord bless you, and may he make you and all of us a blessing to others. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
The buyer.
Asante.
Yedafe.
Tepuhoya.